हेलो फ्रेंड, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू बी एक्सप्लेन यू टाइप ऑफ वेदरिंग। सी द फर्स्ट पॉइंट, एजेंट ऑफ मॉडिफाइंग अर्थ सरफेस। वी नो दैट अर्थ कंसिस्ट ऑफ नंबर ऑफ डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चर्स लाइक हिल्स, माउंटेन, प्लेटूज, सी विच आर गेट मॉडिफाइड ड्यू टू इम्पैक्ट ऑफ डिफरेंट एजेंट्स। And these agents are either external or internal agents. See, exposed rock on the earth subjected to direct or indirect attack of natural and geological agencies. So external agencies are weathering, wind, river, sea and landslide. And internal agencies are earthquake, plate tectonic, groundwater. These agencies are responsible for the modifying the physical feature. They are either constructive or destructive in nature. So it's because of these agents, not only destruction is take place, sometimes more constructive surface area or more newly well-developed structure also develop on surface. In relation to the existing landform at any given point of the time. See, the next is a main factor of agent is weathering. Weathering is a natural process of in situ mechanical disintegration and or chemical decomposition of the rock or crust of the earth by certain physical and chemical agencies of the atmosphere. Weathering, it is a natural process. Because of this weathering, whatever the parent rock present on the surface, it get break and form a different breaking sediments or breaking fragments. So there are three type of weathering basically: mechanical weathering, chemical weathering and biological weathering. The weather product remain lying over and above near the parent rock unless it is removed from there by some other agencies of the nature. See here, this is the parent rock, it get break due to impact of agents, and it break due to impact of, depends upon the agent and the breaking fragments and their property. A weathering classify into three types, and this breaking fragment basically lie on the parent rock or near to the parent rock or away from the parent rock, depend upon the agent which is transported and where it is deposited. So this is the weathering. There are three types of weathering: mechanical weathering, chemical weathering and biological weathering. See, first is a mechanical weathering. Mechanical weathering, it is also a natural process in which what happens, this is a parent rock get break due to impact of different agent like wind or water, and it get break and form a different sediment which has a composition, sediment or breaking fragments form. These have a composition similar to the parent rock and similar to the parent rock. This type of weathering called as mechanical weathering. It is a natural process of in situ disintegration of rock. Disintegration is nothing but breaking of rock into smaller fragment and particle through essentially physical process without change in their composition. Means parent rock get break due to impact of different factors, and in breaking fragments or small pieces are developed, and these are the similar composition to the parent rock. This is called as mechanical weathering. All these fragments and particles, however, have the same chemical composition as the parent rock. It is one of the very common geological process of slow natural rock disintegration in all part of the world. Temperature variation and organic activity are two important factors that bring about this change under the specific condition, because temperature and organic activity enhance this mechanical disintegration. See, first is a frost action. What is a frost action? See here the diagram. This is the one rock which showing the crack, and this crack is filled with the water. And when the temperature is decreases near about 0 degrees Celsius, the water converted into the ice. So this crack is now right now filled with the ice. If it is converted into ice, that time the volume of the water increases more than near about 10%. So volume increases, so this ice can apply pressure on the wall of this fracture. So size of the fracture or distance between this fracture will start to increase. And after some time, what happens? This temperature again increases and this ice again melt and form a water. So when ice curves, or then water converted into the ice, this is called as freezing. Freeze process, I mean ice melt and again convert into water, this is called a thaw process. If freeze and thaw processes continuously happen in one rock for a longer time, then automatically that rock get disintegrate and form a smaller fragment. See, water seep into crack and fracture in rock. When water freeze, it expand about, here you mentioned 9%, and basically it is in 10% in volume, which weighs apart the rock. with repeated freeze and thaw cycle, rock breaks into the pieces. See the frost action. Water on the freezing undergoes an increase in its volume by about 10%. This expansion is accompanied by exertion of pressure on the wall of the vessel containing the freeze water. So that freeze water applies the pressure on the wall of that fracture. This process of freezing of water when the happening within the pores, crack, fractures and cavity of the rock affect them considerably. The original opening are widened at the first stage of the attack and thereby accommodate more and more water to come and freeze in subsequent cycle, therefore disintegration of rock. For day to day like example I'm giving you, we cannot place water into a glass bottle or in a glass of bottle into the freezer, because when water convert into ice, it get expand. If bottle is made up of glass, then automatically the bottle get burst. That's why we use plastic bottle to keep. That's why we use plastic bottle to make ice. Frost action. The next, thermal effect in solution. Thermal effect is similarly to frost action, but here what happen when temperature at particular area is increases, then rock. Because of this temperature, rock get heated, or because of heat, it get expand. And when temperature decreases, it again cool and it get contract. Means is what happen when temperature increases, rock get expand because of heat, and when temperature decreases, it again get compress or contract. Because of this expansion and contraction process, rock get break at particular point and form a smaller fragment. So thermal effect called as insolation. This is also one of the mechanical type of weathering. In arid and desert and semi-arid region where summer and winter temperature differ considerably, rock undergo physical disintegration by another phenomena related to temperature. Rock expand on heating and contract on cooling. Such a repeated variation in temperature experienced by a body of rock gradually break into smaller pieces, especially in the top of layer. So this is called a thermal insulation. Then exfoliation. Exfoliation, just consider one onion. When we want to cut onion, we peel off it and we remove one layer, another layer of onion. Similarly happen with the rock. Because of impact of agent, one layer of rock get removed, another one layer is removed, and look because of this peel off of layers, rock look like this. See, this is the center portion and overlying this is, and another this one layer is peel off from this portion. So, and this is called as exfoliation, also called as spheroidal weathering. This type of weathering take place by two way also, mechanical weathering also and chemical weathering also. But right now we see the chemicals, mechanical weathering. In thick rock body, where the rock is layer, these are the upper layer that get affected most due to the temperature variation. The upper layer may be virtually peel off from the underlying rock mass. See, exfoliation in thin rock body where the rock is layer, and these are the upper layer that get affected most due to the temperature variation. Upper layer may be virtually peel off from the underlying rock mass. In many cases, a change is also accompanied by the chemical weathering, especially at margin and the boundaries of the separated layer develop curved surface. This phenomenon of peeling of curved shell from the rock under the influence of thermal effect in association with chemical weathering is often termed as exfoliation. Basically, exfoliation type of weathering we have seen in the mostly in the basalt type of rock. Then unloading. What is unloading? When confined layer of rock, means one layer and another one layer are deposited one by one, and this is very confined rock. But when the overlying pressure is get removed, so whatever the layer present below, it start to move upward and form a crack around it. And these crack also form crack, or also called a joint form. And because if this crack is more, then obviously the rock get disintegrate or break. Then this type of weathering called as unloading. Large scale development of fracturing confined rock masses is attributed to removal of the overlying rock cover due to prolonged erosional work of other agency. These rock masses remain confined from site, but due to relief of pressure from above, they expand upward. Consequently, joint develop in them parallel to the uncovered surface, dividing them into sheet. The rupturing or jointing in itself is a mechanical breakdown of rock and makes them available for the further weathering or decay along the joint plane. These are the all are the mechanicals, weathering, post action, thermal effect, insulation, and then exfoliation, and then unloading. Then next is a chemical weathering. It is a process of alteration of rock of the crust by chemical decomposition brought about by atmospheric gases and moisture. The end product of chemical weathering has a different chemical composition and proper physical constitution as compared to the parent rock. Chemical weathering takes place in the following way: solution, hydration, hydrolysis, oxidation and reduction, carbonation and colloid formation. So see, first is a solution. Some rock contain one or more minerals that are soluble in water some extent. Pure water is not good solvent of mineral in most of the case, but when the water is carbonate, it is solvent. Action of our many common mineral is enhanced. This limestone is not easily soluble in pure water, but carbonate water dissolves the rock effectively. Limestone get pitted and porous due to chemical weathering. See, this is the limestone, and limestone showing the pitate means small vesicles due to impact of carbonate water. And due to impact of carbonate water, the calcite content present in the limestone get easily dissolved into this. When it dissolves, so that place become empty. So for pitate portion means vesicles are developed, and that vesicle be called as pitate. So because of this solution, this way the chemical weathering takes place. Then next is a hydration and hydrolysis. The exterior of many minerals are not in electrical equilibrium. They may have partially unsatisfied valency. When exterior of many minerals not electrical equilibrium, they have partially unsatisfied valency, means electron moving in the outer shells. When polarized water molecule come in contact with such a crystal, it may causes any one of the following to reaction. Ions tend to hold the polarized side of the water molecule and form hydride. This process of addition of water molecule is termed as hydration. Examples are provided by the hydration of iron oxide and calcium sulfate crystals. In some mineral with ferrous ions and the Fe ions hold the water molecule and form water ion complex or hydroxide. Similarly, CSO4 anhydride gets slowly converted into gypsum by hydration. See, CSO4 and 2H2O. So get combined together, and whatever is the ion present combined with the water molecule and form anhydride converted into the gypsum. This is called as hydration and hydrolysis. This is called as basically hydration. See, water molecule combined with the different ions. So different ion containing the mineral, and they combine with the water molecules and form the different substance. This process is called as hydration. And ion may exchange where some ions from water may enter into crystal lattice of the mineral, and this process of exchange of ion is called as hydrolysis. It's very common process of weathering of silicate mineral and is a base explain and reference to weathering mineral orthoclase and feldspar. See, here what happen in hydration, water molecule combined with the particular mineral and form of one substance. But here is what about only H ions contain of water combined with the mineral lattice and form a different substance. This is called as hydrolysis. See, orthoclase feldspar plus H ion, so form a silicate acid ions. This process is called as hydration and hydrolysis. Oxidation and reduction. Oxidation, ferrous ion of the mineral is oxidized to ferric ion. On exposure to the air rich in moisture, ferric ion is not stable and further oxidized to stable ferric hydroxide. See, 4Fe plus 3O2 form 2FeO3. Fe2O3 plus H2O from Fe2O3H2O. Basically, when we place the iron substance exposed to the atmosphere, it starts to rust. And why it start to rust? Because it react with the oxygen and form acidic substance. So here also that process we call as oxidation, and that process also comes under chemical weathering. Then reduction in specific type of environment, such as when soil is rich in decaying vegetation, minerals and rock containing iron oxide may undergo reduction of oxide to element iron. In this case, decaying vegetation supply the carbonaceous content using causing the reduction. Carbonation is where atmospheric oxygen and water impact combined with the whatever the substance or rock, and because of this reaction, original rock converted into basically original rock which contains silicate mineral start to corrode. And some rock, silicate or potassium, sodium, calcium are particularly start to decay under the condition of carbonation. The next is a collide formation. The process of hydration, hydrolysis, oxidation and reduction operation on the rock mineral under different atmospheric condition may not always end in the formation of stable end product. Other may result in splitting of particle into smaller particles. Formation of collide particle is especially common in the weathering of clay mineral, silica and iron oxide. It forms small particle, and that particle we call as collide particle. And mostly this type of situation happen when weathering take place on a clay mineral, silica and iron oxide. See type of chemical weathering. Reaction with water. Because of this reaction with water, some amount of, if it is carbonic water, what happen? Some part of the particular rock get dissolved in the sensor cavities are developed. Reaction with the oxygen. When react with the oxygen, start to corrode and break. It depends upon the substance, may start to corrode and break and form a small fragment. And then next is a reaction with acidic carbonic acid. With reaction with the carbonic acid, whatever the substance they start to move and remove at particular place. Then reaction with the organism, because of organism, again the breaking of the substance, disintegration will take place. Thank you.